Sure, I'm not. I just want to play.
Thank you.
providing for us. Real field quick, if you would like to take pictures or video, you are more than welcome to. Please refuse from using flash, though. Sometimes the limelight distracts our singers, and they get distracted and start dancing while you're all taking videos. So we want to avoid that as much as possible. Behind me, we have our seventh graders. And our first two songs that they will be performing is Colors of the Wind from Pocahontas and Firefly by Owl City. Thank you and enjoy. class, got like a fun list of songs that they could do, that they chose. And so you kind of get to see inside of each class on who they are just by the songs they chose. And for the eighth grade choir, the song they chose for this evening is The Sound of Silence, performed by Simon Garfunkel. And I've Had the Time of My Life from Dirty Dancing.
Thank you.
is our cancer choir, and we will be singing Man in the Mirror by Michael Jackson and Wagon Wheel performed by Darius Rucker. Thank you. Our last group for this evening is Chamber Choir here at Concordia. With this group, we are doing three separate songs. We will begin with Here Comes the Sun by Beatles, Some Nights by Fun, and then following up with The Lion Sleeps the Night and The Lion Sleeps. Now, recently this group, in all of the first part of the semester, was working really, really hard for festival contests. And typically, we would travel out of town, and we would compete in front of judges, and they would rate us. Well, with COVID and everything, we had to do everything virtual. So we had to record, come in here, send it, make sure we're practiced, and then send it off, and waited for our results to come in. And luckily enough, with our group, we did receive a superior rating, which is a number one, which is the highest group that you can get. I know they were probably getting annoyed with how many times we were running through those songs, but it was well worth it, so please enjoy.
Thank you.
sounds like this one, so come on.
Oh, hello, and thank you for listening to all of us. We are the seniors of Chamber Choir, and we are going to be singing Wherever I Go by Miley Cyrus. Then we will recognize Belle Davies.
We recognize Caitlin Beichman. Next, we will recognize all of the students that were made it into All-State, which is this huge competition in Deal that we have, and many of them. But the students prepare their songs throughout, record, they go through many different levels until they hit it. First one we have is Hunter Blackwood, who made it for an alternate for All-State Mixed Chorus this year. Then we have Belle Shavy, who made it as a soprano for the All-State Treble Chorus. Then we have Caitlin Beichman, who made it as a soprano for All-State Mixed Chorus. And we have Carson Lister, who was a tenor for the Middle Level All-State Chorus. That are all graduating. Oh gosh, I'm gonna get emotional. Okay, for our first group, we have Keidra Strait. We have Nicole Ashland. Caitlin Beichman. And brings in the most choral spirit in our group. And it is done by a vote throughout all the chamber choir, and they vote through our seniors on who they pick. And this year, our National Choral Award goes to our president, Chloe Nelson. Well, Miss Millette, you mean the world to us.
You honestly are such a great role model to all of us. We all look up to you, and we want to be, and we aspire to be like you in our next coming years. So we also wanted to present to you some things. We were going to get you a bouquet of flowers, but they all look dead and not pretty, so we're challenging you to keep this alive. You've kept us alive for so long, making sure we have everything we need. We also didn't know what type of chocolate you like, but we thought that's a great staple for life. And you always are keeping it fresh with us and keeping up with our trends, so we got you some fresca, and it's supposed to be fresca, but whatever. So we just thought this was a way to show that we also very much appreciate everything you've done for us.
Thank you. Thank you. And so he went inside and he knocked on the box and said, "What you give me?" And I looked at my dad and he was trying to use his car as a pencil.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to go ahead and get started. Welcome to the second half of our band extravaganza. The first half was last week with fifth grade and sixth grade, and the second half, also the high school, junior high, spring concert, if you want to call it that, combined choir at 6:30. And thank you for your patience out in the hallway and your indulgence in us setting up and tuning and doing all that. So this is junior high band. It's been a wonderful band to work with. We're going to start with a march that a lot of you out there would know, called the Great Escape March. It gave me a chance to teach these kids and talk to these kids about, yes, there was a movie out there called The Great Escape. Yes, it was based on a true story. Yes, there was a whole bunch of prisoners that escaped, blah, 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 and I have to talk about that. And so some of them recognize this now when they hear it in other movies and things like that. So this is The Great Escape.
Thank you.
the animation film, An American Tale, This Is Somewhere Out There. Before we play our last number with the junior high band, this has been an extraordinary year, to say the least. What a year. And we kind of had to start at the beginning of the year. We didn't have marching this year, so I didn't worry about that. But we got to do a little bit more reteaching than maybe we normally do, because we missed the last 9 weeks of me really working with them one-on-one and such like that. So we got to do a little bit of reteaching. And it took us a little bit longer to gel and things like that. I'm really proud of these kids. I really enjoy these kids. I know some of you out there are going, how can you enjoy junior high? I really do. I actually started teaching as my main job was junior high to start with before I moved into high school. And so I've always enjoyed teaching them. There's like sponges, and this is where the hard work happens, and then it pays off when they get to the older band. So I would like a few individuals to stand because they really haven't been able to get recognized this year. I had several individuals that auditioned. This year, auditions for KMEA were done via recording instead of live. They're always going to be recorded, but we didn't get to have any band or anything like that. So I had several students that auditioned for KMEA, and let's see, I'm going to have them stand. So it was Dagan DeGraw on alto sax, And then it was Francisco Ayala on the tenor sax. And we had Kate Roth on Barry sax. And then we had Kyle McFadden on tuba. And we had Aubrey Stallman on bass clarinet. And then I believe we had another one, but she moved on, unfortunately. She moved to a different state. I don't know what to think of that. So, anyway, give a round of applause. I did forget one. I forgot Brigham. I knew I was going to forget somebody. Brigham Shavey, he also. They came in, they worked extra during pause, and thank goodness it was all this year. We went to a different system where everybody was basically playing the same music, so we were able to rehearse a lot better instead of everybody doing individual things. So, the last number we're going to do, the kids, I think a lot of them have enjoyed it, some of them haven't enjoyed it, but it's kind of in the, it's a little bit of a tongue-in-cheek kind of piece, but it's supposed to be kind of in the characteristic and of Aaron Copland and those kind of like Billy the Kid that he did and things like that. So I think you'll enjoy it. This has three movements to it. Three movements. So there'll be movement one and just slight pause, and movement two, slight pause, and then movement three. And then that'll be the end of the piece. So the movements are, the first movement is, I want to make sure I get these right. So it is Prairie Ritual is the first movement. And then the second movement is Rain on the Mountain. And then the last movement, of course, is Train Heading West. So I think you'll enjoy this.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is the high school band, and we're going to open with the main theme to The Incredible. I used some YouTube videos and things like that, and I was demonstrating the trombone of all instruments for the fourth grade. And this guy that I showed before had this arrangement he'd made with trombone quartet of Let It Go, and all the kids started singing it as it was playing. And it must have done the trick, because, you know, I'm not quite done doing all the fourth grade instrument selections. I already have like six trombones, and that was the instrument they wanted to play. So, I must have done the trick or something. Anyway, so I heard it. I was like, man, that's a really cool song. I think we can do this nice. Anyway, so this is Let It Go from Frozen. and selection somehow never gets old. Seems like you pull it out every few years. And with the Hobbit movies that had come out after The Lord of the Rings, and it was still popular, and so people seem to like it. It has a lot of solos in it that are mainly going to be from seniors and such. So I hope you enjoy this. This is Highlights of Lord of the Rings.
Thank you.
instead. But it's okay. We'll get to them. Been a really, really, again, like I said earlier, been an interesting year. Been some challenges here and there, but we made them work. I never thought in my lifetime that I would be doing a whole marching show at a four-step interval, which is like 8 feet apart, but we did it. We pulled it off, made it work. It was a great show, so I was really, really proud of them. We had a huge number, I think 11 color guards, that was the first time in many, many years since I've had that many. Usually I only have 8. Maybe think back to my days when I was flying south, we had like 16. So that was really kind of a nice thing to see. And so it's just been an incredible year, interesting year, but a wonderful year. Been a great band. First time we did get our superior rating at festivals, which is for the, 35, 36, something like that. I'd have to figure it out. 36 or 37, I was kind of figuring it out one time. So, like 36 consecutive years. This year I was a little unsure because, you know, we had to record it and then we had to send it in. It's like, it's not really in your power. It's kind of a weird thing. So, you know, 36 consecutive years, probably, that's a pretty good streak. So, yeah, round of applause for that. We also had some ensembles that we had to record and then upload those, and we had to scan the scores, upload those, and it was kind of a royal mess. We were not the only ones this year that were in that kind of a situation. So, we did have an ensemble that got a superior rating, and that is the Woodwind Choir. They would stand and be recognized. The Woodwind Choir. Really proud of them. So, really proud of them. And there was no regionals in state this year. It was just one festival. And again, you know, a little uncomfortable because it's kind of out of your control. You're just not sure who's judging you and how they're going to judge you. Are they going to judge you the same as this? Or are they judging 6A to 5A and then also 4A? And is it like they judge 5A and 6A wins on top? I don't know. Anyway, there's a lot of things running through my mind. And then lastly, I do have one individual to recognize that made the district band. We have a few people that auditioned for district band, district KMEA band, and this person made it, which is really hard in this particular instrument that she's in. That's Sam Dierdo on alto sax. Difficult thing in alto sax because there's like, you know, they usually only take like 4 or 5. I don't know how many they took this year, 4 or 5. And there's like 30 that audition. You know, so the ratios usually aren't exactly on your side, but I was really proud of them for that. So, and then lastly, the group of people that, they are the leaders in this band. They've been here for 8 years. They have put their time in. They've been with me through a lot, and even went on a trip with me and survived, or I survived, one of the two, and really proud of these guys, and 8 years, it doesn't seem like 8 years. Some of you, I remember, like yesterday, like you were still in fifth grade, so if the seniors would please stand and be ready. And we do have one last award here. It is the John Phillips Souza Award that is voted on by the band and is given out to the person. I tell them you need to vote on the person that best exemplifies what this band is and the leadership and musicianship and going above and beyond call of duty and always there and things like that. And some years I can kind of tell and go, well, I bet it'll be between these people or whatever. This year was like, it could be any one of them. It was just that kind of a class. This person obviously gained a lot of respect from the band, and I think it was a good choice. They all would have been a good choice, but I think this one was a good choice. So the John Philip Sousa Award goes to Easton Atwood.
Thank you.
think that's, is that it? Yes? Okay, because they gave me my gift way back in, usually they give a gift, but they gave it back at Christmas time because that's when Keegan Grogan was still here before he moved on. And so they gave me my gift, which I've been using all semester. So, yeah. So, anyway, I just want to say thank you. The seniors will have one last time. This won't be the last time they'll be playing with us. They do have one last time. They'll be playing on Sunday. So, that'll be it. And like I always say, you know, I'll remember you and I'll be thinking of you until that first marching band rehearsal, and then you're out of my mind. Because my mind is on to the next year. So anyway, again, I just want to say thank you to the seniors and to the whole band in general, and look forward to next year and what we're going to do. So the last piece we're going to do, with some of the turmoil and things that's been going on in our country, and for whatever reason, and we shouldn't be going on at all, in my humble opinion. We're all Americans, regardless of what we believe. Some of us believe one way, some believe in another, but that's not to say that either way is wrong or either way is right. That's my soapbox. And we're all Americans, and we should be treated that way, regardless. So I thought to myself, this year, this would be a great piece to end with. So this is America the Beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming. See you next year.